So I'm the co-founder of Anrami. I'm the technical product guy. I live between the pixels, the data, cloud, and trying to create something new for Anrami every day. So right now we're launching several features, which is dynamic creative personalized audios, allows people, every user might get a different audio creative depending on so many segments that the advertisers want to reach him, whether it's the first time he got the audio ad, or whether it's morning, or whether it's actually he's biking. So the ad might actually refer directly or indirectly to the fact that the user is now in Dubai, it's morning, the weather is great, it's fit for biking. So that might be a different message than for someone who's actually driving, a woman in her 30s. So basically we can do creative audio advertising. This is something that's new, and we can do it in sequentially. So the first time we introduce something, the second time something else, so multiple audio ads. But now we're available on a variety of devices. As we mentioned, we're available on phone, tablet, web, desktop, mobile progressive web app, which is the first in the world. You can open a browser on your mobile, right, play.anrami.com, and you have a full Anrami you can use. You don't need to download an app to listen to music. That gets more people into it, and later on that we can upgrade to the Anrami app if they want. We're available in car, on Jaguar, Land Rover, any CarPlay-enabled device, so it's like over 30 cars from Apple. We're going to be available on Android Auto by the end of the year. We're available on speakers. We're available on TV, Apple TV, Android TV, Chromecast, on the watches of Apple and Android. We're available roughly everywhere the user is, and that's why we're happy about our 53 million users, and we're growing. Most of those users, like a big percentage, is in the Middle East, between GCC, Levant, Egypt, and Maghreb, almost at a quarter from those four segments. We're very happy of our growth. We're happy about our 81 minutes time consumption per day, and
Per user,
per
for a
user,
number of users.
per user. It's an average per number per user. Clearly, we have users who are using Anrami for many, many, many hours. We're happy about those, but we're actually very happy about our new users exploring and seeing what Anrami can offer to them, because we're adding much more in technology in terms of understanding the user. That's built on our music DNA, whereby we understand what the user like, how he uses Anrami, and what type of music he likes to listen to, the genres, the decades, the mainstreamness, the explorer or not. Whether it's those data enables us to know what we want to offer to the user.
Ellie, what about music? I mean, the rights to music. How do you acquire most of the music?
We acquire all of the music legally, with negotiation with the labels. So we have 26 million songs available today. Everything from, your rock star, your metal music, your indie music, your Arabic music, your Indian music, anything is available.
So where's the capital for that coming from? I mean,
I mean, we've raised multiple rounds, right, to grow Anrami. And Anrami started by as a maybe joke or an idea to do something that we would love. Right, because we love music, we didn't have a way to listen to music legally, and variety of music, and we created Anrami. But obviously, a lot of partners have been on board, whether NBC, MEVP, Doom, Samina, Mobily, so many other partners have worked with us, because we have a connection with over 22 mobile operators, whereby enabling people to subscribe, upgrade to their. Using their local mobile operator, because credit card penetration is still low in the region. We rely mostly on mobile operators.
Mostly your revenue comes from subscription numbers or ads?
Okay, so basically our revenue, 40% of our revenue comes in from advertising, 60% is from subscriptions. So we want both of them to keep growing. Ads is important. We're today talking about audio and advertising as a whole. We think audio advertising is extremely powerful, because it allows you to target one message at a time to the user. The user cannot be listening to two messages at the same time. He cannot be seeing in a banner, it's another banner from here, a video from here. He's fully concentrated. One audio gets at the same time in his ear, which is very powerful. And we believe the audio ad business in the region isn't as evolved at all to what it can be. We started that like a couple of years ago, but today we're doing another approach and a bigger one. We're going to be doing way more because we're putting data with the advertisers, with the agencies, enabling them to really push to more, getting one message at a time in a world whereby right now we're targeted by so many ads at the same time. Is refreshing. It's refreshing that Al-Ghami can do that, and we hope we can do more even.
So you're competing with radio advertising?
We're competing with radio. We cannot not say the word. Yes, we think we are, and we think because we know that the difference between radios and us is that we are the first pan-Arab radio station, and there is no particular competitor over there. Yes, so we are the only audio station, radio, whatever you want to call it, whereby you can launch a song and reach at the same time millions of users from Oman all over to Syria, to Egypt, to Libya, to Sudan, to the entire GCC, basically. And that you can do it only with Al-Ghami. There isn't. That's why the competition thing that you're mentioning is there, but it's actually not really there because we're talking different.
Yeah. So if I'm an artist and I put my album on your thing first, what's the revenue model for me?
Basically, we like to share. Everything is in a really fair, equitable sharing. So we take 50 and we give you 50. The 50% we take is to run, to make Al-Ghami, to grow that Al-Ghami, and you get your fair share. And you have the ability to upload your music directly to Al-Ghami, and to, after signing the rights and validating that you own the music, because we don't, legal is really paramount over here. And we don't risk that. And that's how we can grow, by being 100% legal.
What's the biggest challenge at the moment?
We have multiple challenges, but I think the biggest challenge is really getting the word out that Al-Ghami is better than any other alternative. And so far, our user base is really agreeing with us. We think we have a lot because we think the penetration is still fairly low relatively to what we can reach. We have to be dominant, we have to reach more users, and with the growth of smartphone, really, it's really helping us. Clearly, piracy is a global problem we have in the Middle East. The restriction, I mean, piracy isn't being fought directly by governments and everything, and that's really our biggest challenge, right? Compete with piracy, and we think that we are pirating the pirates. Pirating the pirates by providing an entire catalog, which is with high resolution audio, with a great user interface, all the music available on your fingertips. You pay for a premium subscription, less than the price of a burger.
How much is the subscription?
It depends, but it goes up to $5 at most, right? So roughly less than 30.
Monthly subscription?
Monthly, yeah. I would say like less than 20 dirhams for the entire month. So basically you can either get a burger, enjoy like your 5 minutes, or you can get Al-Ghami and have a full month of enjoying, and maybe get a burger too.